Good afternoon. Welcome to the clinical meeting for 2019. Start on time, finish on time. I want to thank Vinita. She's put together a new system based on the clinical meeting. There was a guru, she would just come to meet each other. I also want to thank Java for taking the video taping of this. Live cast to full campus for this type of thing. Share of people to the mission of see the digital meeting live, the global platform. So that's very good. So, the best that we hope is to be able to do this. So, I'll hand over to you that briefly tell us the new rules and then we'll get started. Thank you.
I think the rules have actually been circulated into your WhatsApp group, so please have a quick look at it just to make sure that everybody's on the same platform. We want you to know that strictly time will be followed. You will be given 15 minutes for each case, 10 minutes for the presentation, and 5 minutes for discussion. Okay? Now, if you cross the 10 minutes, at 10 minutes, we have Dr. Ebenezer and Dr. Zakaria who are timing the whole thing. At 10 minutes, there will be an indication saying that you're at the 10th minute. If you continue proceeding, presenting, you will be allowed. But 1 minute before the 15th, it's your 14th minute, there'll be a 1 minute warning. At 15th minute, you will be asked to stop. There'll be a placard that will be shown saying, stop, please stop. Failing which, we'll have somebody to escort you back to your seat. And if you keep doing that, you will automatically get an E grade. Okay, so that's about it. We have actually three judges for today, Dr. OC, Dr. Tambu, and Dr. Audrin, who will be doing the judging of the cases. Now, if you do very well, you get exciting prizes. We've not told you what the prizes are. Each time it will be different. You get it today. But if you don't get an A grade, there will be a discussion. And next week, if you do qualify, that is B grade, then you will be able to get a prize. But if you get C or D, you don't qualify for any prize. So anyway, all the best. We'll start now. The first case from Medicine 1, imbalance leads to imbalance. Please speak into the mic, and even the discussants, the mic will be sent around. Please speak into the mic so that it could get recorded.
Good evening all. I'm presenting on behalf of Medicine 1. My topic is imbalance leads to imbalance. Mr. X, a 40-year-old married male from Tamil Nadu, is working in education department as a superintendent. His main complaints are progressive difficulty in walking due to unsteadiness for 5 months. In August 2018, he had mild imbalance while walking. In December 2018, his imbalance worsened, especially on closure during bath, and he noticed a slipping of feet without his knowledge, and he had a mild stiffness in the both lower limbs, and he had no vertigo or dizziness while standing up, no reported weakness or no incoordination of the upper limbs. There's no behavioral changes, and he had mild forgetfulness. No history of alcohol consumption, and he's a pure vegetarian. He's a mild imbalance walking, maybe like ataxia, and it's worsened while closing his eyes. It may be posterior column involvement, like back pain sign, and the slipping of feet seems to be a sensory impairment, and stiffness of both lower limbs, be upper motor neuron or corticospinal tract. And there is no vertigo, if you rule out vestibular component, and there is no dizziness to rule out orthostatic hypotension. No reported weakness, there is no motor weakness, and no incoordination, no, there is no. So there is no cerebellar symptoms. And there is no behavioral changes, and merely cognitive impairment is not there, and is not a depressive. He is a pure vegetarian, seems to be low vitamin B12 level, seems to be subacute combined degeneration. And significant medical history. In 2016, he had right lower limb cellulitis and had non-healing ulcer in the right lateral malleolus. It worsened, became in January 2017, he was in pain, so they underwent doctor screening. He found to be deep venous thrombosis. He was treated for 6 months with acitram. In July 2018, he found to be he had generalized weakness. He told he had hemoglobin of 5.8, mild hydrate. He took some iron injections. In September 2018, became 12 grams. In December 22nd, till now he is working well. On 22nd, before going to his work, he lost his balance while changing the bike gear. He couldn't, and he fell from the bike with his children. And followed by, he developed cellulitis both lower limbs and admitted in CMC, treated with antibiotic. But on 24th December, he had sudden cardiac arrest in the ward and they stated. And 30th December, he was discharged and sent home with a Zincovit tablet. But he presented to 8th January 2019 with difficulty in walking, presented to medicine field. On physical examination, he is moderately built and nourished. His BMI is 28.5 and BP is 110 by 70. Mild pallor and mild streak also. Mild bilateral pedal edema is present. And there is hyperpigmentation of palms and knuckles. Other system, CVS RS per abdomen is normal. The CNS system is MMSE is 27 by 13. Cranial nerves are normal. Motor system, upper limb motor system normal. Lower limb, there is no weakness, wasting of muscle. And the tone mildly increased in the both lower limbs. The power grade 4 in all group of muscles in lower limbs. Deep and down reflexes, bilaterally 2 plus upper limbs and brisk knees and ankles are 1 plus. No clonus, bilateral plantars are upgoing. The sensory, there is decreased pain and touch below knee and vibration sense. And joint positions, they impaired at grade 2, and the roundup time is positive. There is no cerebral or signs. Gait is broadways using walker. Hyperpigmentation of this. From the history, it seems to be like myeloneuropathy involving posterior column involvement because of impaired vibration, joint position sense, and falls to roundup step. And corticospinal tract, because spasticity in lower limbs and reflexes are brisk and extensor plantar going. And the neuropathy slipping of footwear without awareness and imbalance while walking and decreased sensation below knee. From the differentials, from the metabolic vitamin B12 deficiency or vitamin E, copper or folate deficiency, toxic organophosphonates, and infective causes HIV, TB, and HTLV, chikungunya virus, autoimmune like sarcoidosis, Sjogren, malignant paraneoplastic lymphomas, and other hereditary things like purpural predicate ataxia, and medication induced nitrous oxide, clinoquil, and anti cancer drugs. From the investigations, we thought probably subacute combined degeneration because hemoglobin is 9 grams and MCV is 105, RDW 23.2% and is total also low and total bilirubin 2.10, direct bilirubin 0.58, vitamin B12 levels are 110 and folic acid 20 and his other TSH, copper, VDRL is negative and parietal cell antibodies are positive. So pure vegetarian and classic girl pattern involvement and low vitamin B12. So most common cause like sort of subacute combined degeneration of spine. This is from the approach conclusion. It is difficult to diagnose. In our patient, we started him on high dose of vitamin B12 and asked to review after 1 month with the repeat levels for reassessment. Any worsening plan for the evaluation and also check for zinc levels at review. And in mineral deficiencies such as copper and myeloneuropathy, mineral excess disorder has zinc induced copper deficiency. And in zinc containing dentures or high dose proton pump inhibitor intake can cause copper deficiency. This minimum this approach to ataxia. In ataxia, there is imbalance in gait. There is a balance coordination in the sensory and motor, and sensory visual and vestibular and proprioceptive systems in the lower limbs. The motor systems, the muscle strength, upper motor and the lower motor, those regulate the coordination in the cerebellum, and those that are involved in the muscle tone experimental system. Those coordination is imbalance, then attacks will happen. Non-neurological causes may be painful joint and orthostatic hypotension. Psychological, like ataxia, abasia, there is inability to stand properly. From learning points, history and a clinical examination can help make a diagnosis and how to approach a patient with ataxia and neurological manifestation, vitamin B12 deficiency and many causes of myeloneuropathy. The patient would need to be followed up. Vitamin B12, a common reversible cause of subacute combined degeneration, and to look for other causes, especially if no significant improvement.
Found that vital antibody is positive. What does that mean?
The autoimmune process, like
if you look for any other autoimmune syndrome that could coexist. Go on to the second.